Hey guys, it's Emma Vigeling with TYT Politics. I hope everyone is having a great day. Today, I really want to talk about Senator Cory Booker from New Jersey and the bill that he introduced in the Senate. It came as a surprise to me because I have been very critical of Cory Booker in the past, and I think rightfully so. Most infamously, he was a part of the Pharma 13, the 13 senators that voted against Bernie Sanders and Amy Klobuchar's drug importation bill that would have allowed drugs to come over from the border in Canada, from Canada, to reduce drug prices for Americans. And it was a pretty no-brainer bill, but they voted against it. And when the bill was reintroduced recently, Cory Booker was standing side by side with Bernie Sanders to reintroduce it and is now working with him on it because the political fallout was so great. That example, paired with his massive amounts of donations from the pharmaceutical industry, make him kind of a questionable figure in terms of healthcare on the Democratic side. So that's why this new bill that he introduced in terms of marijuana was really surprising for me, a great surprise, because the bill is actually awesome. A new bill in the Senate would not just end the federal prohibition of marijuana, but encourage states to legalize pot as well. The bill proposed by Senator Cory Booker on Tuesday would remove marijuana from the federal scheduling system, which is the basis for its federal criminalization. This isn't new in the Senate. Senator Bernie Sanders, for one, also put forward a bill that would deschedule marijuana back in 2015. Where Booker's bill goes further is it actively encourages states to legalize cannabis. Specifically, the bill leverages federal funds to incentivize legislation in states that have enforced laws against marijuana in a way that disproportionately impacts low-income people and people of color, a category that includes virtually every state. A 2015 report from the Sentencing Project, for one, estimated that Black Americans are 3.7 times as likely to be arrested for a marijuana possession as their white counterparts, but only 1.3 times as likely to use pot. The measure addressed two layers of prohibition. Under current federal law, pot remains illegal even in states that have legalized, creating big barriers to states that have legalized, including restrictions on business tax deductions and access to banking. But whether marijuana is legal, decriminalized, or illegal at the state or local level is decided through state or local law, meaning that a city or state could conceivably keep marijuana illegal even if the federal government removes all its own restrictions. So this is a great bill from Cory Booker that even goes further than Bernie Sanders's bill back in 2015. Now, Bernie's bill had theoretically a chance of passing under a Democratic president. Booker's bill has zero chance of passing, but it is so great that he's introducing it, and I was really happy to read that. But it couldn't get passed. Cory Booker was one of the senators who was the Pharma 13, who's so pro the pharmaceutical industry, who receives massive amounts of donations from them. And now he's flipped and is wanting marijuana to be legal throughout the entire country. So I looked into it a little bit further and I saw this. NASDAQ reports Pfizer, Merck, and other big pharmas likely to acquire marijuana-based drug companies. Medical marijuana generated more than $4.2 billion in revenue in the US in 2015, according to the ArcView Market Research. And they forecast it will surpass $22 billion by 2020 as regulations continue to loosen and patient access increases. So why is GW Pharmaceuticals, the largest pharma company with a relatively modest market capitalization of $2 billion, developing marijuana-based drugs? Where are Pfizer, Novartis, Merck, Sanofi, and the rest of the big pharma brethren? If there's a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, you can be certain they'll be in the mix at some point, most likely via the acquisition route. In fact, ArcView predicts that once the behemoth multinational corporations enter the market, they will likely go on the acquisition spree versus directly competing against companies that have years of experience of navigating the complex market. So let's break down one of the biggest companies listed that might acquire marijuana companies, Merck. Merck is based in New Jersey and is one of Cory Booker's biggest donors. Merck gave more money to Cory Booker than they did to any other candidate in 2014, giving him $12,500. That is also outside of any PAC activity because a lot of this money is so shrouded in secrecy due to our crazy campaign finance laws. I can't really give you the exact number, but they did give more to him than any other candidate, in 2014. Cory Booker also spoke at Merck's conference in a paid speech that is not included in that total. That paid speech was in 2014. Even back when he was mayor of Newark in 2013, when he was running, they must have donated a ton to him at that point, he name-dropped Merck, saying, "Merck, a pharmaceutical company in my city, 60% of the people they hire as biomedical statisticians are from outside the country because they can't find Americans to do these jobs." So really, Merck and Cory Booker have kind of been in cahoots from the start. Big Pharma in general has donated around $395,000 to Cory Booker in his career, close to $400,000. One of the other companies listed that was a big part of that total and that is likely to acquire these marijuana companies was Pfizer. What about Pfizer and Cory Booker? In the 2014 election cycle, Pfizer's top two recipients were both Democrats, Representative Joseph Crawley of New York and Senator Cory Booker of New Jersey. They gave him $24,550. While Crawley sits on the Tax Law Writing Ways and Means Committee in the House, Booker is the member of the Senate Committee on Commerce, Science, and Transportation. Both panels make significant decisions affecting pharmaceutical manufacturers. So you see where this is going. For the other companies listed that might acquire these marijuana companies, in 2014, Novartis gave $7,000 to Cory Booker, and Sanofi gave the same amount of money that was just in his 2014 election cycle. The lesson here is not that this is a bad bill. It's quite the opposite. It's a very good bill. And I'm really happy that it's introduced, and I agree with it on the substance. But it goes to show that this is how Cory Booker operates. Even when he's doing something good, it's because he's trying to appease his corporate donors. We don't know this for a fact. Yes, I'm speculating, and I'm connecting some dots. But I can't see how he can make a jump from Pharma 13 to introducing this massive overhaul in the right direction of marijuana policy. It doesn't seem consistent. And when there are inconsistencies, you usually have to follow the money. Again, I'm really happy about the substance of the bill. But if we want good things to happen for consumers and for people in America and for income inequality to be addressed, we can't just bank on corporations falling into doing the right thing sometimes and their money doing the right thing sometimes. The fact that Booker is beholden to them, and when he does something that's so great, it's likely motivated because of money, doesn't make him an actual representative of the people. It makes him representative of corporate interests. And there are way, way too many senators and representatives who behave in the exact manner as him. And it's frustrating that he's going to use this, I assume, in 2020 on his campaign platform to say, look how progressive I am and how I'm not beholden to the pharmaceutical industry, when he's really just investing in the future of the pharmaceutical industry, which sees the writing on the wall and knows that marijuana is going to be the way to go, no matter what Jeff Sessions has to say about it in the near future. So, Cory Booker, don't be fooled. He is still the same guy that he was when he was in the Pharma 13. It doesn't matter that this bill is great. Who he is at his core is not a progressive. And in my opinion, I would go this far to say as he is fraudulent in the way he makes himself out to be to the American public. Don't be fooled by Cory Booker. Have a great day, guys.